I would like to introduce someone to you, the planet Venus, one of our neighbors in the solar system. Named after the Roman goddess of beauty and love, Venus is the second closest planet to the Sun. However, despite being the second nearest planet, Venus still manages to be the hottest among all eight planets in our solar system. Exceeding even Mercury's temperatures, which is the closest planet to the Sun, Venus is truly hell. This image taken by the Venera 13 probe shows a little bit of what the surface of the planet is like. The probe lasted only 2 hours and 7 minutes before the electronic systems fried due to the temperature. However, what if I were to ask you which planet in the solar system is the most similar to Earth? I know we are in a video where the title talks about Venus, so the answer to this question is kind of obvious. But still, using intuition, many would answer Mars. When we hear about the search for water, the search for life, or even the preservation of the human species, it is Mars that our thoughts are directed to. Almost all manned missions that are being planned today have as their goal the planet Mars, and some even study the possibility of creating a colony on the red planet. Hardly anyone would think of Venus, which is the planet where it rains sulfuric acid and temperatures can reach almost 500 degrees Celsius during the day. And despite all of that, yes, Venus is the planet that is most similar to Earth in terms of size, mass, density, and composition. We even have evidence that Venus and Earth formed practically at the same time and with the same ingredients because both were in the same region of the nebula that formed the solar system. Venus, the planet that is now practically a hell, is considered the twin planet of Earth. And some observations suggest that they have always been practically the same since they formed and in the early years of their lives. And FYI, when discussing the initial years in astronomy, we typically refer to billions of years. Still just a baby, but something happened at some point that made Venus become a true hell, while Earth continued its path as the habitable planet that we know. So, the question that remains is, how did Venus turn into hell? To answer that, we will need to take a journey through space and time. Approximately 4.6 billion years ago, the solar system was a gas and dust nebula. We still don't know exactly what happened, but something destabilized this cloud and caused regions of it to collapse under its own gravity. Some suggest that this something was a supernova that happened near us. Most of the material from that time, and we're talking about 99% of the mass, became the Sun, while the other 1% was divided into planets, asteroids, and natural satellites. But the focus here is the formation of the planets Venus and Earth. Because they are planets considerably close to the Sun, the two possibly formed when a core formed for the first time from the collapse of the gas and dust cloud, and material was being captured by this core through gravitational interaction. Both Venus and Earth are in very close regions, so it is expected that the composition of the two during their formation was the same. And indeed, both possess an iron core, a mantle made of magnesium silicate, and a crust composed of silicate. This in itself does not hold much significance because we have two other planets with comparable characteristics that also originated in neighboring regions. What is remarkable is the fact that Venus and Earth possess remarkably similar sizes and masses. Venus is only 5% smaller and less dense than Earth, that is practically the same size, same mass, and same volume. Two planets formed practically together with similar characteristics, unlike Mercury and Mars, which are much smaller and less massive. And the similarities are not just in size. The atmosphere of Venus and the atmosphere of Earth were also quite similar, with a carbon dioxide to nitrogen ratio of 97 to 3. Basically, they were two similar spheres born almost simultaneously and with identical composition. But then, what occurred for Venus to transform into this inferno that is so distinct from Earth? The answer begins in the early years of the solar system. The inside was chaotic, very chaotic. Asteroids, planetoids, and objects came from all directions and places, drawn by the Sun's gravitational field, attracted by its powerful pull. Planets collided with planetoids, asteroids fell into the Sun, or they would hit planets all the time. And this made the inner part of the solar system become a true battlefield where only the strongest survived. And it was here that two important things happened. First, we believe that a small planet called Theia collided with Earth, and the result of this collision was the formation of the Moon. The collision changed the rotation period of the Earth, bringing it closer to what we know today. Additionally, the Moon has and continues to play a vital role in stabilizing Earth's rotation. This is one reason why the day has the duration it has. And secondly, Venus was also subject to impacts during this time, and one reason for its axis of rotation being opposite to that of Earth may have been a large collision. This collision would not only have stopped the rotation of Venus, but also reversed its direction. Yes, Venus rotates in the opposite direction, likely due to a collision. And this greatly complicated the situation of Venus. A day on Venus lasts 243 days on Earth. And one day on Venus is longer than 1 year there. And the year on Venus lasts for 224 Earth days. Unlike Earth, which gained a natural satellite as a bonus, Venus has never had a natural satellite. Despite this seeming inconsequential, this was one of the first things that made everything start to go wrong for Venus. The reason is that our moon helps to keep the rotation axis of our planet stabilized. Venus does not have this, and therefore, does not have seasons. It is thanks to the tilt of the Earth's axis that it is possible to have seasons. This means that the climate is not homogeneous, as various regions receive varying amounts of sunlight at different times throughout the year. Furthermore, this also means that the climate can remain stable for long periods of time. Venus has just a 3-degree inclination, as opposed to Earth's 23.5 degrees, which enables the occurrence of seasons in our planet. In other words, Venus has a uniform climate everywhere all the time. Another thing that works against it is its position in the solar system. Venus is the second nearest planet to the Sun, and that also means it gets more sunlight than Earth. If today, with the Sun already in its adult life, it is enough to be catastrophic, when the Sun was young, it was even worse. Young stars are brighter and more energetic than older stars, and this also applies to the Sun. Any resemblance between stars and your favorite rock star is not mere coincidence. We can estimate that Venus, when young, received 40% more sunlight than we receive here on Earth today. The proximity of Venus to the Sun possibly caused all the water that could exist on the planet to evaporate. Venus is not in the habitable zone, and it's even funny to realize that Venus is right on the edge, outside the habitable zone, while Earth is right on the edge, inside the habitable zone. And I'm starting to get a feeling that Venus is just a very unlucky planet. Another curious thing is that there are signs of water vapor and mainly deuterium in Venus's atmosphere. This is interesting because when the water molecule is split into oxygen and hydrogen by the sun's ultraviolet radiation, some of the hydrogen is deuterium, a heavy isotope of hydrogen. Deuterium can't escape the atmosphere unlike oxygen. Therefore, we estimated the quantity of water on the planet based on this information. Recent simulations show that Venus could have had oceans for billions of years, and that they could have existed while life was already happening on Earth. So even with everything going wrong, Venus was still trying. Misfortune always loves a little bit of company. We have a few more things that worsen the situation on Venus. One of them is that Venus does not have tectonic plates, and you must be thinking that this is not even something so important, but maybe this was the last nail on the coffin for Venus. Tectonic plates on Earth play an extremely important role in cycles such as water and carbon dioxide. There is a whole process where carbon is released into the atmosphere through geological processes by tectonic plates and returns to the mantle because of them. This was crucial for the greenhouse effect in Earth's past to retain heat and maintain an ideal temperature for preserving life. In addition, the plates are related to the geology of the Earth, from volcanoes to mountains, which are important for the climate. As the pressure inside the Earth can be relieved in other ways, at the edges of the tectonic plates, volcanic activity is not as intense as it could be. And that's exactly what happens with Venus. The lack of tectonic plates on the planet prevents the carbon cycle, basically causing all carbon dioxide to concentrate in the atmosphere. To make it even worse, with pressure from the core unable to be relieved in other ways, the only remaining alternative is volcanic eruptions. Venus has a lot of very intense volcanic activity, which causes greenhouse gases to be released into the atmosphere at all times and in large quantities. To give an idea of comparison, the amount of carbon dioxide in Venus's atmosphere is 96%, while on Earth, it is just under 0.04% of the atmosphere. The atmosphere of Venus has a pressure 90 times higher than Earth. It is too dense to observe the planet's surface in the visible spectrum. And if you were on the surface of Venus, it would be impossible to observe stars. And all this arrangement creates temperatures sufficient to cause the melting of lead on the surface of the planet. And that's not even mentioning the fact that volcanic activity is also responsible for releasing sulfur dioxide, which produces clouds of sulfuric acid. In other words, it can rain sulfuric acid, a true hell. But if we stop to think, there is not a single cause that alone is responsible for turning Venus into a hell. It was a succession of events since its formation. But if we need to choose the biggest culprit, it would definitely be the lack of tectonic plates. It seems that while the tectonic plates on Earth saved our planet from hell, their absence on Venus destroyed any possibility of life or a better environment. Maybe this was the decisive thing that turned Venus into a hell. But now comes the plot twist and an opening for a possible existential crisis of the video. The concept that Venus never had tectonic plates or only had one large plate for much of its existence is accepted by scientists. However, this does not explain the amount of nitrogen present in Venus's atmosphere. These quantities would be impossible without tectonic plates. Recently, astrophysicists published in the journal Nature a result indicating that Venus may have had tectonic plates in the past. In the study, they show that only tectonic plates can explain the atmosphere of Venus today with the amount of nitrogen that is observed. And the best part is, not only did it have tectonic plates, but it could have been habitable and very similar to our planet between 2 or 3 billion years ago. And this raises a question about the habitability of planets as something more temporary than we imagine. In fact, this may also apply to Earth itself. Is Earth an exception, or will we have a future similar to Venus? And who knows? This new knowledge may even make us look at planets that at first we thought were uninhabitable and how we search for life throughout the universe with different eyes. It is still not known what causes tectonic plates to cease to exist, on Venus for example, that turned the planet into a hell. This remains an open question in astronomy and planetary sciences. However, just the answer already opens up new questions, such as, for example, were we observing this all this time in the wrong way? Maybe life is more common than we thought? Did Venus ever harbor life? Is this going to be the future of our planet? I hope not. But the truth is, we do not know. Thank you very much, and see you next time. And do not forget to subscribe to the channel and leave your like.